She bumped into me.
Well, well. I'm Franky.
I'm Karen.
You're beautiful.
Are you in here?
That's right. Right here.
Who else?
Doreen. What'd you do, Karen?
I stabbed someone to death.
Always like a challenge. Life, eh? Me too. We'll have a happy time together, Karen. It's up to you, love. You can really enjoy yourself if you put your mind to it.
I'm not like that, Franky.
You're going to have to be, and anything you don't know, I'll teach you.
Get your hand off
me! Don't say anything you might regret, Karen. We're going to be in here night after night for years and years and years.
Mom, I want to sell on my own. I won't share with that animal.
Animal, am I?
You stupid girl.
Why are you moving me?
Why, indeed?
You can't move her.
We can do anything we like, Doyle.
I won't let you move her.
The decision's already made.
No! Doreen stays with me!
What's the matter? Scared of getting lonely at nights? Come on, out! Move!
Franky?
Get up.
Bet you're dying for a cigarette.
Yeah.
Pity. Against regulations.
Hey, I forgot to tell you. We got a new nickname for you. It's old B's idea. You know what it is? Vinegar tits. Hey, how about that, eh? Vinegar tits.
You really are the most uncouth slut, Doyle.
Oh, don't blame me, Vera. It's old B's idea. She thought it up.
Did she indeed?
Vinegar tits. Doreen! Can you hear me, darling? Doreen? Can you hear me, love? Doreen!
What?
You love me, darling? You miss me, darling?
Doreen!
Oh, shut up!
You'll never take over from B, Franky. You're too stupid. That violent temper of yours is going to let you down every time.
I'll take over. You watch me. The girls will do like I tell them. Once Queen Bloody B's out of the way, you screws her in for a dog's life.
Try it. You'll end up back here in the pound every time.
You want a bet? What are you doing operating that press anyhow?
I should have thought that would have been obvious.
I operate that press, no one else.
Sorry, I thought B. Smith operated it.
B. Smith is out. I'm in charge of the press now and everything else around here. Now get out.
You don't scare me, Franky.
I will, love. I will.
While I'm here...
Keeping your hand in, are you?
What do you mean?
Digging holes. Better look out, love. She'll be burying you alive next.
Oh, God, how many more times I didn't do it?
Of course you did it. You put that little boy into that hole. That's what you did.
Leave her alone, Franky.
I'm not gonna leave her alone. And one dark night, I'll...
No!
Fix her. Oh, gee, sorry, I'm just so clumsy. That's my trouble.
Big...
Oh, you want to fight, do you?
Just leave her alone! Stop it! Leave her alone! Frank, get away from her! Leave her! Stop it!
She's off a flaming rocker, that's what happened. I come over here to smell the flowers and she took to me with a shovel. Is that true?
No. Well, what difference does it make?
All right. One more incident from you, Doyle, and you'll be back in solitary.
You come with me, Doyle. I've got something to show you. Come on. Well, Franky, what are you going to do now? Sit there all day? I don't mind. But isn't it about time you made a move?
I'll move you, bitch!
There'll be no showdown. Not while I'm in charge.
But you're not in charge, are you? Not behind these bars. And if any of yous forget it, just remember, we've got Mick Jackson.
Frankie! It's Bill Jackson. I want to talk to you.
Hear that? Your old man wants to talk to me.
I wonder what he wants.
Perhaps he fancied you. He's not my type. All right. You want to talk? Be at the gate in 5 minutes. Just you and that screw with the keys. Nobody else. And remember, no tricks. What do you want?
I want you to let Mrs. Jackson out.
Why should I?
Frankie, you're not doing any good by holding her. You're only putting yourself in a worse mess.
Not going to be worse than this.
You could spend the rest of your life in here. Look, B should never have been allowed in with the rest of you straight away. She should have been kept in solitary. Now, if you let Meg out, I'll testify before any inquiry that this trouble was caused by the authorities breaking their own rules. Look, you've nothing to lose by letting her out.
Okay. Open the gates. This dance?
I've booked her.
Well, so that's how it is with you two, is it?
Piss off.
Come on, Lizzie, up you get.
Oh, God. All right, ladies, all together. And...
I warn you, if you spoil my class... All right, everybody, on with the dance. Oh, get ready.
Come on, Lizzie.
My teeth, you lousy bitch!
You see what happens when I'm not around to look after you?
You took them. Now give them back!
You gotta learn, Lizzie. No one holds out on Frankie. You're gonna wind up like that idiot who wouldn't eat. Except you won't be able to eat.
Anyone seen Lizzie? It's not like her to miss out on a feed.
She's going on a diet.
Must have been a real drag bringing up a kid brother, eh?
No.
But I'll make it up to you. I swear.
You just keep your nose clean, that's all.
Frankie, I won't be able to come visit you for a while. I've got a job on a farm near Walla. Leaving today. It sounds great. I couldn't just pass it up. And I'll be able to learn all about farming and stuff. So when you get out, we'll be able to get our own little place. All right. Let you know how I'm getting. Nah, got a better idea. I've got a mate. You can drop in and visit you. Let you know what's happening, huh?
Yeah, sure. Well, see you in a month then. I miss you, Franky.
Yeah, me too, Gazza.
I don't know how much you got owing to me, but it must be a bit. Been saving for 2 years.
The money you don't spend in here is supposed to be held until your release.
Yeah, but I want my brother to have it. I'm going to be stuck in here for years. He needs it now.
Well, I'll see what I can do, but it is irregular. What's your brother's name and address?
Gary Doyle. Oh, I don't know his proper address. Mate of his will let me have it.
All right, leave it with me. Before you go, I'm aware there are certain tensions amongst the women. I was hoping that someone like yourself, for instance, may be able to stop things before they get out of hand.
Can't help how they feel.
No, but I'm expecting you and some of the others to set a good example. You've been behaving yourself quite well lately. I'd hate to see anything happen to spoil that.
Hey, Doreen?
Yeah?
You want to hear a fairy story?
Oh, I'd love to.
Well, once upon a time, there was a little girl that was locked up for being naughty. And her kid brother said, why don't you get a parole? And then we can live happily ever after on a little farm way out in the country. Only trouble was, she couldn't behave herself long enough to get a parole. The brother got sick of waiting, moved up the cross, and became a poofter.
Oh, that's nice.
Truth of the matter is, I got lonely for you. Did you miss me?
No.
I missed you. Bitch. You keep. Yeah, well, B and her mates are going to get what's coming to them, and when they do, I don't want to see you getting hurt.
Why not?
Because I think there's something special. You're sick. Yeah, well, that doesn't mean I won't hurt you if I have to.
I've called her. She's on her way.
You want to see me?
What do you want me to do about it?
Don't know. Nothing.
What's wrong with your eye?
Oh, I've got something in it, so I can't read. Doc put some drops in. When he was a kid, it was me did all the worrying. Now it's him.
Yeah. Franky?
What?
Doreen told me that you received a telegram.
You can't keep your trap shut for 2 seconds, can you?
Oh, I didn't mean to.
Yeah, well, my eyes are better now. I read it for myself. Last time I asked you to do anything.
You read it?
Yeah?
Franky, I think I should read you that telegram. Now, it's nothing to be ashamed of.
What do you want about?
A lot of people can't read.
You bloody monster, Claudia!
You know what was in that telegram, Franky. Your brother's been hurt. Very badly.
It's critical.
Sorry to hear about your brother, Franky. Now, I'd like you to come with me to the office. We could ring the hospital and find out his condition. Get this mess cleaned up, please, Miss Bennett. Yes, I see. Thank you very much. His condition is still critical. I'm sorry, Franky.
What happened to him?
The tractor he was driving turned over. He was pinned underneath.
I've got to see him.
It's not quite that simple. I don't have the authority to give you permission.
I've got to see him. You can't stop me.
Miss Doyle? I'm afraid I have some bad news for you. Your brother died a few minutes ago. If you'd come a few hours earlier, he did regain consciousness and ask for you. He held on for as long as he could.
Look familiar? Geez, you'll have to grow up a bit before you fit into that, Gazza.
You don't care?
Nah, all they'll do with it round here, except scare a few screws.
3 years of you me trying to get us a farm. At least put a deposit on one. But you've got to promise me you won't get into any trouble.
up here?
What the hell do you want?
Church service must be just about over by now.
So what?
Everyone will be coming out soon.
You keep away from me!
Well, I reckon you're piss weak, Franky. You can't talk to me like that. What a piker! Frankie!
He was only doing it for me.
The poor little bugger got himself flattened by a
For me, his dumb ups of a sister who can't even read.
Done a bit of reading, eh?
That's right.
Reckon you can teach me?
Everyone.
Everyone. Yes. Grandmother and grandfather, come for the party.
Oh, Franky, that was terrific. You must have really worked hard last night.
I'm doing good, eh?
You're doing very well.
Yeah, I'm doing
well. Look, shall I read for a bit and you follow? Bob blows out the candles and makes a wish.
Behaving like some mad thing.
Oh, I'm sorry. All right, you tell me what to do and I'll do it.
Too right, you bloody will. You get us shot, then I'll have your guts for garters, Doreen. And get this through your thick head. I'm never going back there. Never.
Don't be depressed, Franky.
I'm not bloody depressed.
You were pretty sweet on that Karen Travers, weren't you?
Bloody little snob. Talking down to me. Doing me favours.
Yeah. She wasn't your type. You want to stick to your own sort.
Do I?
Yeah.
See that coming?
Morning sickness.
It's lunch.
She's late. Better see how she's getting on.
Hey, Tommy. Couple of smart Sheilas. Give us a hand, will you?
Come on, Frankie! Come on! Oh, jeez!
You smart ladies, only $12.50.
Come and get it, Dickhead. Forget it, Doreen!
Gutless wonder!
Frankie!
Stop that!
No, Frankie, what?
No, he'd only see us. Quick, in here.
Dunno.
Look where we are.
Oh, God.
Oh, Franky, they'll help us.
You're off your rocker.
No, nuns are kind and they're taught to help people who are poor and in trouble. They won't turn us in. And they probably haven't even got a TV, so they wouldn't know who we are. And just think, they could give us some real food and a bed. A real bed.
They're a mob of bludgers and they turn us in for the reward.
Oh, Franky, do you think they've got a reward out on us? Yeah, I knew you were pulling my leg.
You shut up, Doreen. I'm trying to think.
Streets. And stop walking like you've got a long pants on. Oh, come on, Franky. What was wrong with that place? He must have been 100.
Oh, God, Doreen, you just don't think, do you? He said he was living with his daughter.
Yeah, but she wasn't home. And we could have knocked over the place before she got back.
We're sticking to our plan. We're going to find someone who lives by themselves.
Do you realise you're the first visitors I've had in about 2 months?
You, don't have a family?
Yes, but I'm lucky to see them once a year.
But surely the neighbours pop in now and then.
People don't want to seem to spend the time these days. Once you're old, you're forgotten. Oh, but I'm so rude. Please, do come in, sisters. I'll make a cup of tea. Do you do this sort of work all the time?
Oh, yeah, it's part of the vows we took. It's a full-time job looking after those people who are in need of comfort and help you keeping this place going and getting to the shops.
And the bank?
Oh, I manage. I don't need much. And what's in the bank stays there. You see, I keep a little money hidden here in the house for anything unexpected that might pop up.
Oh, that's handy.
Yes. I don't think I'm taking any chances, really. It's not much. It just saves a trip.
Franky!
What?
Have you forgotten who you're supposed to be?
Bad chance with you carrying on like something out of the Sound of Bloody Music.
Yeah, well, you're going to blow the whole thing if you're not careful.
Suits me.
But I'm staying here. I like it, and I like her.
If I say we're going together. Remember, I give the orders round here.
But this is better than being on the run all the time. We're safe here, aren't we? No one would ever think of looking for us here.
That's your story. Oh, McBride gives me the creeps.
Can I get you anything, sisters? So nice to have you here. So kind.
Sisters, you'll really have to come out and have a look at the garden. The passion fruit's gone mad. I'll have to give some to the neighbours.
Well, maybe later. We're not really the outdoor type.
Oh. Well, 6 o'clock. I think it's time for a sherry. I don't suppose I could tempt you to join me. Just the one.
Well, wasn't really allowed at the convent, but since it's a type of wine, I don't suppose the good Lord would take offence to you, sister.
Not if we had just the one.
Good. I was sure it would be all right.
I don't want to lay the old bag out, but I'm going to have to if you spill the beans. All right. She wouldn't.
There's no need to say any more, dear. I don't want to hear it. I've always known exactly who you were, Franky. The moment you both walked through the front door, I knew. I may live alone, but I know what's going on outside. Look, I don't care what you've done. It's been wonderful having you here, and as far as I'm concerned, you can both stay as long as you like. It's up to you.
L-U-C-K.
Yeah, I can spell it. I'm not stupid.
Yeah, but you said you wanted me to help you.
Yeah, blind leading the blind. Finish. Here, read it.
Dear Karen.
Go on.
Well, you're doing real good. Sorry I'll give you a hard time. Good luck.
Yeah, that's fine.
How'll she know who it's from?
She'll know.
Sure. Hi, how are you? Well, happy birthday, Artie. This is for you. Can't stay long, just thought I'd pop in and see how you were. Well, it's the right day, isn't it?
Yes.
Well, open it up. Yes. Yes, you've got some lovely stuff here, aren't you, lovely?
Yes, I know I have.
There, you see? I knew it was the right day. Get me worried for a minute. Look.
Trevor, it's been lovely to see you again, and thank you for the delightful present.
We haven't even opened it. Oh. Look, I'll just pour myself a drink while you finish unwrapping it. Fresh glass through here.
Oh, no, don't.
G'day.
G'day. Trevor, these are my friends. This is Doreen and this is Frankie. We've been having a little party.
I didn't know you had any friends called Doreen and Frankie.
Well, you do now, don't you, Trevor?
Hello, put me through to the police. Yes, it's an emergency. Hello, look, I've got to talk fast.
You'll have to talk faster than that, Trevor.
For a minute. I know you two are. I've seen your photos in the paper. And you're holding my auntie a prisoner in her own home, aren't you?
Yeah, that's right. We're holding a prisoner. Think you're clever, don't you?
Yeah. It's dead easy, silly old cow.
Put him in here, Frankie. There's lots of room in here. And it's got a key, too.
In. One word out of you, Trevor, and I'll be calling you Sally. Better tie the old bat up and gag her.
Here you are, dear. Oh, and take this too. You'll need it, I should think.
Oh, Miss McBride, you shouldn't.
Don't be stupid. Thanks, Auntie. See you around. Come on, you.
Hey, Doreen. You're not running out on me, are you?
Stupid lug. We're a team, aren't we? For a few days, till we think of something else, okay?
Dirty mongrel. I'll kill the bastard.
He's gone.
I'll find him and I'll kill him.
No. You were right, Frankie. We shouldn't have stayed here. He hurt me, Frankie.
Let me murder him.
No. I just want to get away from here.
You look after yourself real well when I'm not here, don't you? Can you give us a look at your face? Oh, jeez, you're going to have a shiner in the morning.
I don't want to stay here, Frankie.
He won't be back till tomorrow, will he? So we're in no real hurry.
I really don't want to stay here, Frankie.
Now look, you've got to have somewhere to stay tonight.
Yeah, but...
You've got to have your rest. Besides, I've got my own reasons. I won't let him hurt you, Doreen. Just leave everything to me. I reckon it's Doreen's turn to take a walk this morning.
Hey?
Yeah. And it's about time you got yourself a real Sheila. What do you think? You're really going to enjoy this morning.
Christ.
What's the matter, Toddy? Scared? Oh, no, not you. Not a big bad bastard like you. You like to beat up on little girls, don't you?
And now listen, Frankie, on it.
Shut up!
Frankie.
Yeah?
Thanks for looking after me.
Yeah, well, next time you get any bright ideas, don't.
What are we gonna do now?
Been sleeping on something.
Yeah? What?
Have to give it a bit more thought.
Bit lower. No, no way, I'm not gonna do it, Frankie.
Use your head, Doreen, it's the only chance we got.
A bank? When was the last time you were in one, huh? There's cameras and alarms.
Look,
and
you
all
said yourself you want to get out of Melbourne, you've got to have money to do that.
Yeah, but I'm not holding up a bank.
But will you listen to me for a minute? It'd set us up for life. We could get a little place in the country. Gaz and me was always going to do that.
Yeah, but your brother wasn't going to rob a bank. It's dangerous.
It'll be a cinch. All you got to do is check it out, wait for the right time.
Yeah, but you were put inside for doing a dumb job like this.
This'll be different. I've learned a lot since then. I'll look after you, Doreen.
Oh, yeah. Like the last time. Well, your girlfriend copped it, didn't she? She's dead. Well, there's no way I'm going to wind up dead. I'd rather turn myself in.
If that's the way you feel, why don't you?
Come on, Frankie. We could think of something else. A petrol station or a shop, maybe.
Yeah, we hang around Melbourne much longer, we're going to get caught. And I'm not going back inside. Do the job on me own.
Oh, you can't, Frankie.
Then give us a hand. Let's go.
Now?
Yeah, now. There's only one person in there. Let's go.
Now?
Yeah, now. There's only one person in there.
He's following us, Frankie.
Get out of here, Doreen. Run.
I'm not leaving you, Frankie.
You still got a chance.
I'm not leaving.
I've had it, Doreen. You can still make it. Bloody get out of here.
I'll see you, Frankie.
Now get the hell out of here.
Bloody bastards!
We were friends.